Hello students, welcome to today's session. Today we will see nested queries in SQL. First of all, we will see what is the requirement of a nested query. Actually, in some applications, we may require the existing value in the database to be fetched, and it may have been used for a comparison condition. That is, we have to fetch a set of values which are already existing in the database, and one attribute may have to be compared with this existing values. So in that type of applications, it will be easy to represent as nested queries. Actually, as the name indicates, nested query means query inside another query. In a nested query, inner query will be always executed first, and then the outer query will be executed. We will see an introduction to nested query today. First example, retrieve the name of all employees who have salary greater than the salary of all employees in department 5. So here, first we have to retrieve the salary of all employees in department 5. That is written as an inner query here. So this is the inner query. Select salary from employee where department number equal to 5, which will retrieve the salary of all employees in department 5. Now we have to retrieve the name of employees who have salary greater than the old salary of department 5. That should be written as the outer query. Select name from employee where salary greater than the result of nested query. So the salary of each employee will be compared with all salary from department 5. So if this condition is satisfied, then the name of employees will be retrieved. So this is how a nested query is written. We will see another example. Retrieve the name of each employee who has a dependent with same name and same gender as the employee. So here we have to check for two conditions. The employee's dependent should have the same name, and employee must have the same gender as that of the dependent. So the conditions are written in the inner query here. Select d.essn, where d is a tuple variable of the relation dependent, from dependent as d, where these are the two conditions. e.name equal to d.name and e.gender equal to d.gender, where e is a tuple variable of employee, d is the tuple variable of dependent. Actually, here we are creating tuple variables because the attributes name and gender are same for both the relations. Here we can see in employee relation there is an attribute name. Same attribute is repeated in the dependent relation also. Similarly, there is an attribute gender in the employee relation. Same attribute is repeated here in the dependent. So in such case, we will create tuple variable. So the conditions are given in the nested query or in inner query. Then we will retrieve d.essn, that is SSN of employees who have a dependent which satisfies this condition. Then this ESSN will be compared with e.ssn. Here there is a keyword in is used to compare these two attributes. So the query will be select e.name from employee as e, where e.ssn in, now the result of inner query. So the ssn of each employee in the employee relation will be compared with essn in the dependent relation, which satisfies these two conditions. So if this comparison matches, then such employee's name will be retrieved. So it's clear, in this type of comparison application, it will be easier to represent as a nested query. Now we will see another function in SQL, that is access function. Access function in SQL is used to check whether the result of an inner query exists or whether the result of an inner query is empty or not. The result of exist is a Boolean value. It will be true if the inner query result contains at least one tuple. So if the inner query has a result, then exist function will return true. If the inner query result has no tuples, then exist function returns false. So exist function is usually used along with nested query. We will see example. Retrieve the name of each employee who has a dependent with same name and the same gender as the employee. The same example we have considered before. So here, just as before, the conditions are specified in the inner query. That is, we are comparing the gender and name of dependent with that of employee, and e.ssn equal to d.essn, that is also given as a condition here. Now if all these conditions are satisfied, we are retrieving the tuples which satisfy the condition, that is select star. Now if such a tuple exists, if the result of inner query has at least one tuple, then this exist function will return a true value. Then we are retrieving select e dot name. That is, if such a tuple exists, then we will retrieve the employee's name from that tuples. So that is how exist function works. So exist function works along with nested query to check whether the result of inner query exists or not. So the conditions must be given in the inner query. If the condition is satisfied and if such a tuple exists, then the result of the inner query will be passed to the outer query. Another example, list the name of managers who have at least one dependent. Here the relations are given: employee, department and dependent. Two conditions are to be satisfied. First condition is the employee must be a manager. In the question it is given, list the name of managers. So the first condition is employee must be a manager. Second condition is the manager should have at least one dependent. That is, he should have a dependent. So to check whether an employee is a manager, we have to use employee relation and department relation. Because in department relation we have an attribute manager SSN. So if an employee's SSN matches with manager SSN, then we can say he is a manager. Then second condition is the manager must have a dependent. So there we are using employee relation and dependent relation. If employee SSN matches with ESSN independent, we can say that employee has a dependent. So these are the two conditions which should be satisfied. If both these conditions are true, then retrieve that employee's name. That's what we have to represent as a query. So the query can be written as select name from employee where exist. Now the first inner query will check whether an employee has a dependent. Then there is another inner query which will check whether the employee is a manager. Now two inner queries are connected with logical AND operation. So only if both the inner query results in true, the logical AND will return true, then the employee name will be retrieved. So this is an example of how exist function works in SQL. The same query can be written using tuple variables as we have studied before. Select e dot name, we are specifying employee's name from employee as e, where exist, select star from dependent as d. D is a tuple variable of dependent, where e dot ssn equal to d dot essn. We are comparing employee's ssn is same as dependent's essn, and exist. Second inner query is select star from dependent as dp, where dp is the tuple variable of department. So this is for checking whether the employee is a manager, where e dot ssn equal to dp dot manager ssn. So you can represent the query either by using tuple variable or without tuple variable. Now next is not exist function in SQL. Actually, not exist function is just the reverse of exist function. It will return a value true if the inner query has no tuple in its result. If the inner query has at least one tuple in its result, not exist will return false. We will see one example. Retrieve the name of all employees who have no dependents. So we have to retrieve the name of employees who have no dependent. So the condition must be SSN of employee should not match with ESSN of dependent, where ESSN in the dependent relation represents the SSN of employees who have a dependent. So SSN should not match with ESSN. That is a condition to be checked here. So the condition is written as the inner query here. Select star from dependent, where SSN equal to ESSN. So this retrieves all the tuples which satisfy this condition. If such a tuple doesn't exist, then retrieve the employee's name. So we can see not exist is just the reverse of exist function. If the inner query returns false, then not exist returns true. So here, if the inner query returns false, that is, if a tuple which satisfies this condition doesn't exist, that means there is not an employee who has a dependent, then that employee's name will be retrieved. Next is explicit set of values in SQL. Explicit set of values can be used in SQL with in keyword. In is a keyword which is used to compare an attribute with an explicit set of values. One example is given. Retrieve the SSN of all employees who work on project numbers 1, 2 or 3. So we have to retrieve the SSN of employees who work on project either 1 or 2 or 3. Employee and works on relations are given. So here the query is written as select distinct ESSN. We have already studied distinct keyword. It is to avoid repetition in the resultant relation. So select distinct ESSN from works on, where project number in 1, 2 or 3. So here the explicit set of values 1, 2 and 3 are given in the condition in the where clause. So the attribute project number will be compared with 1 or 2 or 3. Then if it matches, then that will be, that SSN of employee will be retrieved. So this is how explicit set of values are specified in SQL. So explicit set of values are always specified along with where clause in a select statement. So that's all about an introduction to nested queries. I hope the concept is clear. The next session we will see more details and more functions which are used in nested queries. Thank you.